Hello friends, you are welcome again to the continuation of our electrical wiring project. Alright, so at this stage, we are going to connect the switches and the sockets that we need in the wiring. And that also goes with assembling the consumer unit. Good. But before then, in a previous video, I left something out. And so I'm going to do that before we continue with the fixing of the accessories. And that is, I needed to draw neutral wires for the lighting system. So I'll do that briefly and then we continue with what we have to do today. Alright, so now the next thing we do, we'll first fix the sockets, then we move to the switches, then we move to the lamps, and then the bell. We are going to put all the yellow and green wires together. And that connects to the terminal by E, or the terminal with the N symbol. And then we put all the blacks together and connect them to the terminal by N. And then we put all the reds together and connect them to the terminal by L. If you want a detailed explanation of how to wire sockets, you look down below this video. I have a very comprehensive video on how to do that. Alright, so in order to prevent unnecessary open circuits or break in the connection of the wires, it is always advisable to twist the two wires together wherever you are looping, so that even if it comes out of the terminal, the cable will still continue to the next circuit. All the conductive parts of the cable must enter into the terminal. Only the insulation must show, and that is for safety reasons. So it's very important when terminating the cables, you make sure that no conductor is outside the terminal. Thank you. Alright, so please, if you have not yet watched the previous videos, you would have to go back and look at them, because all this thing that we are doing here has been explained earlier in the previous videos. Alright, so because of how we want this wiring to work, all the switches here are going to be one gang, one way switch. But usually, the commonest switch you get on the market these days is the one gang, two way switch, which can also perfectly be used for this arrangement. So we are going to use one here, and then one here. And each of them will be controlling each of the three lamps at the top. This one will be for the bell. Okay, so here we are done with the connection of our sockets and the switches. So we move to the lamp holders. So we are now going to connect the lamp holders. Alright, so now we are done with fixing our sockets, our switches and our lamp holders. So the next thing we are going to do now is to assemble the RCDs and the breakers in the breaker box to meet the need of our wiring. And as I said in the previous video, we are going to add some more breakers to cater for the future expansion of our installation. If you want a closer look at how to assemble the consumer unit, I have a special video on that stuff, and so you would have to look for that and then watch.
Okay, so we are making progress. I had wanted to add the assembling of the consumer unit to this particular session, but since this is a series, I would like to end this particular one here, and then I'll continue in the next video. So in the next video, I'm going to show how to assemble the consumer unit. This consumer unit is a customized one that we are going to create for this particular wiring. There are certain important explanations I'll be doing around the assembling of the consumer unit. And then one important thing that will feature in the next video is also to show how to connect the various circuits to the right breakers in the consumer unit. In case this is your first visit to my channel, I'll recommend that you subscribe so that you don't miss out on any of my videos. And in case you have found this video very useful, don't keep it to yourself alone. Share it with others so that they also benefit from it. Don't forget to subscribe and stay connected. See you in the next video.